Hey guys, Bman coming to you from Penny Lane, of course, and welcome to this theme month. As you tuned in on Wednesday, you know, Plots told you that there's five Wednesdays in this month. So we're doing a one-hit wonder theme month. And basically, one-hit wonders are either a person or a band that has had one and one only hit in the top 40 charts. And we're using the US charts. Last year, around the same time, we did Forgotten Artist theme month, where we picked hits that time has probably forgotten, but they were great hits. So this time around, we thought we'd do one-hit wonders. And the reason I mentioned last year, because I'm going to do the same thing this year, is I added a little flavor to that, and I decided to do it. I'll take a hit from each decade for five decades, starting with the 50s. And I'm doing that again this year. So for week one, I'm going to do a song from the 50s. Week two will be the 60s. Week three will be the 70s. Week four will be the 80s. And then week five will be the 90s. So I'm going to start this out with a song called To Know Him Is to Love Him by the Teddy Bears from 1958. Chart-wise, it hit number one in the U.S., number two in the U.K. It was a huge hit pretty much all over the world. So I guess with no further ado, right? Three, two, one. Ba 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 ba. To know her is to love her. Just to see that smile made my life worthwhile. To know her is to love her. And I do. Love that song. So now let me tell you about this song. Like I said, it's called To Know Him Is to Love Him, or To Know Her Is to Love Her, or to know, yeah. and it's by the Teddy Bears. It came out in 1958, but there are different versions. And I like, you know, for me, since I'm talking about her, I thought I'd use her. And people, different people, depending on if it was male or female that was singing the lead on this, would convert it from him to her. So what about this song? First off, the song was written by none other than Mr. Phil Collins. Not Phil Collins. Holy cow. Phil Spector. And for those of you who are like, Phil Spector, yes, Phil Spector, the famous music producer. So he formed the Teddy Bears. And for the Teddy Bears, in the Teddy Bears, there's Phil Spector, there's Marshall Lieb, there's Harvey Goldstein, there's Sandy Nelson on drums, and then there was Annette Kleinbrow, who was the lead singer. So the cool thing about this song is not only did Phil write this song, he arranged it, he played on it, he was an engineer on it, he produced it. And this song ended up selling about 2.5 million copies. Huge hit for him. And the thing is, Phil, when he did this, was only 19 years old. And it's like he had the Midas touch, because from then on, he helped all sorts of artists. But let's talk about this song. It had different versions. So for them, they hit number one and number two. Then in 1965, Peter and Gordon, which I did a song for Peter and Gordon not too long ago, they redid this song, and it reached number 24 in the U.S. and number 5 in the U.K. Then in 1969, Bobby Vinton did a version of it. And it reached number 34 in the U.S. and number 6 on the Canadian charts. And then on the U.S. Easy Listening chart, it hit number 8. Then in 1987, the trio, Dolly Parton, Linda Ronstadt, and Emmy Lou Harris, released a version of the same song. And they hit number 1 on the U.S. country charts and then number 1 on the Canadian country charts. Now, there are other acts that have also done this song. The first act that I ever heard do it was not the Teddy Bears, it was the Beatles. I was listening to the anthology and also the Beatles live at the BBC, and I heard this song, and I was like, holy cow, this is a great song. They never released it on any of their albums, but they had it. They played it live at the BBC, and then they also had it. It was on their anthology, which was, I think this was part of their set that they did for Decca, when they were auditioning for Decca, who turned them down. And fortunately, they did, because Brian Epstein took those tapes to Parlophone EMI, and of course, the rest is history. But it George Martin, and then there you go. But other acts that did it, like I said, were the Beatles, Jody Miller, and also Amy Winehouse, who did a version of this song, too. Now, back to Phil Collins now. Phil Collins, so he forms this band, have a huge hit, and then he goes on to produce a lot of cool acts. For instance, did you know that he was the producer on the Beatles' Let It Be album? And Phil Collins became known as that guy with the wall of sound. He actually revolutionized studios, that music, to make the studio sound an actual instrument as something to use along with music to enhance it. Great thing. So he not only did that thing with the Beatles, but he also produced several John Lennon and George Harrison single albums. He also was a producer for the Ronettes with Ronnie. We eventually married Ronnie Spector and the Ronettes. The Crystals, Ike and Tina Turner. The Ramones, and also the Righteous Brothers. Now, I was like, wow. So Phil was huge in the 60s and 70s. But then what kind of happened? What happens to a lot of artists? Drugs. Phil got into drugs, and then he started having erratic behavior, and he just kind of faded away. And that's what happened. Until Phil actually got... Phil ended up going to jail for the murder of, what's her name, Lana Clarkson in 2003. He ended up going to jail in 2009, where he died in prison in 2021. I know, what a sad ending to a guy that started out so well and did so well with his career. So, all you kids out there, say no to drugs. I couldn't help it. Sorry. I love that. But it is funny how you'll find these people that do really well, and then they get involved with drugs and all sorts of stuff, and right down the tubes. So, anyway, that's kind of the story on this song and Phil Spector, who, like I said, a giant in the industry back in the day. So I think that pretty much covers the song. Anyway, I really like this song. And did you notice? Not a sad and melancholy tune from the B-Man, right? Happy, upbeat, to know him. Oh, I forgot. So Phil got the title "To Know Him Is to Love Him" from his father's gravestone, because that's what it said on the gravestone. To know him is to love him. And he liked that phrase and turned it into a song. And now you got this whole rest of the story stuff, right? I know. So hope you enjoyed that. Next week, I'm doing a really great song from the 60s. It's one of my favorites. I have another cool story about that one. So if you enjoyed the song, how about giving it a thumbs up? If you have heard the song, would you let me know which version you heard, you know, whether it was a Teddy Bears or whether it was Peter and Gordon or Bobby Vinton or Dolly Parton and the Trio or any of the other acts like me where I heard it from the Beatles first. So let me know about that. If you enjoyed Stella's performance, because give it up for Stella, how about being kind of nice and leaving her some nice comments? I guess that's all I got. So don't forget to tune in to week two of our One Hit Wonders. Plots will drop a new song on Wednesday at 1 p.m. I'll drop in another one on Saturday for week two at noon. So until then, peace out, live long, and prosper.